The CEB Engineers Union says that they will intensify their trade union action in protest over the failure to implement the long-term power generation plan. Its president Soumya Kumaravadu said that a final decision is to be made next week.
After the Narachalai plant was added to the central grid, the country has not received a power plant that could resolve the power crisis in the country. We have been engaged in a struggle for the last 3 to 4 years, demanding that our plans for a solution be approved. Our executive committee will convene next Tuesday and decide on our future course of action. Engineers of the CEB have not engaged in a strike since 1996. Even then, the strike was for a national issue. We don't just go into strike actions. If we do not get a solution soon, we will go for a trade union action. The Public Utilities Commission, an independent commission tasked with regulating public utilities, had requested the CEB to amend the generation expansion plan, taking into consideration environmental and cost concerns with regard to coal power plants. It is under Section 43 of the Electricity Act that we are entrusted with the authority to approve the power generation plans of the CEB. Accordingly, it is a plan that has a minimum cost that can be approved. The plan changes as per the data included in it. The CEB has quoted $69 per ton of coal, but in the market it is about $81. At the same time, the CEB has estimated about $10 for natural gas, but in the market it is $8.4. When we looked at the plans with this new data, we see power generation through natural gas to be less costly. There have been numerous substantiated reports of the environmental damage caused by thermal power plants, including the Narachalai coal power plant. Meanwhile, the Sunday Times newspaper, quoting the Coalition Against Coal, reported that the Narachalai plant does not have a valid scheduled waste management license as required by law for a facility that generates hazardous matter. When News First inquired into reports of faults in the machinery used to dispose of toxic smoke from the power plant, authorities at Narachalai assured us that repairs had been carried out. Meanwhile, the Water Supply Joint Trade Union Alliance says the union action that was initiated by the Water Board employees with regard to salary arrears is continuing. The Postal and Telecommunication Officers Union says that they will engage in a trade union action from midnight today, citing several demands, including the failure to appoint permanent postmasters.